morning, Home Gardens. I'm Katie.
And I'm Jasmine. Welcome to HGA TV.
So now, won't you prepare for the Pledge of Allegiance? Please stand. Put your right hand over your heart. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the student pledge. Raise your right hand. Ready? Begin.
I am responsible for my own success. I will achieve all my goals through hard work and determination. Today, I will make the choice to be a positive influence on my peers, my school, my family, and my community. I will put 100% into everything I do.
I will take my education seriously to be prepared to go to college.
Tuesday and Thursday, fourth graders will begin state testing. Good luck.
Before we get into the rest of announcements, here are two more test-taking tips from Danny and Manny.
Tip 7, solve the easiest problems first. Don't stay on a problem that you are stuck on too long, especially if time is a factor.
Oh, it's easy. It's 2. Yeah.
Tip 8, when you're done with your test, go back and double-check your answers, such as any questions you have skipped.
Attention Home Gardens Academy, our soccer game will be Tuesday, March 4th. We will be playing Citrus Hills. The game will be held at HGA on our own field. Girls play at 3:30, boys play at 4:30. Be there to support our team.
Attention Home Gardens, there's going to be a book fair. It's open this whole week before and after school. It's open for all grades in room 102.
Hey Home Gardens, there's going to be a parent university meeting this Tuesday, March 5th at 5:30 p.m. This meeting will be held in the multi-purpose room. The topic is mechanic basics.
Hey. Attention Home Garden students, this Friday there will be a college pep rally at 8:25 a.m. So make sure you come and get excited by your favorite college. Remember, you can show your spirit by wearing a sweater or a shirt from your favorite college. If not, then your school uniform rules still apply.
Hey Home Gardens, Student Council is sponsoring a dance for 4th, 5th, and 6th graders this Friday in the multi, 2:40 to 4 o'clock. The price is $2 per person.
For this week's Amazing Kid of the Week, Mrs. Verdugo chose a 6th grader who is a great example of the kind of kid we're looking for.
Strong academics, athletic, and respectful. Have you figured out who?
But first, let's check in with Sarah for a few words of wisdom.
Good morning, Home Gardens Academy. I'm Sarah with a few words of wisdom. All of us make mistakes. It's part of being human. Some of the mistakes we make are small and come with small consequences. Other mistakes are big and the consequences can be serious. Now listen to the words from a great American writer, Pearl S. Buck. Every great mistake has a halfway moment, a split second when it can be recalled and perhaps reminded. In other words, somewhere in the middle, we can make a big mistake. We can stop and choose again and perhaps avoid the mistakes altogether. Next time you think you might be making a mistake, remember Pearl S. Buck. Stop for a second, take a breath, and choose something different before it's too late. With something to think about, this is Sarah. Make it a great day or not, the choice is yours.
The thing that I like about HGA is that it's not messy like other schools.
He's well known for being an incredible athlete.
My favorite hobby is running and playing other sports. My favorite type of game is FIFA 13. My favorite sport is football, and my favorite team is Chargers.
Whether it's basketball or soccer or track, he's phenomenal. But he's also a great, great, great student. He has wonderful student skills. He's great with his homework. He works really hard for his academics.
My secret to getting good grades is studying before tests.
He has a lot of goals and ambitions other than just sports. And he's liked by all, gets along with everybody, always demonstrating terrific kid qualities.
The things that I like about my family is that they're athletic and fun. My favorite book is Freak the Mighty.
Overall, very, very much a great part of an example of a home garden student.
Last week, we had guest readers on our campus reading their favorite children's book in the classrooms.
Did you receive a visit from a guest reader? We put together a little slideshow to show you how it went.
But first, did you know we have a club on campus called FBLA? We interviewed a few members to tell you more about it. Let's watch.
FBLA is a club, and it stands for Future Business Leaders of America. And it basically prepares kids for the future.
And what it is a nonprofit organization ran by students. It's the largest organization in the world that's ran by students, and it works with local businesses to help the city with community service.
I like that we get to get involved with our community and are able to sell things and do community service and things like that.
I got an award for marketing in eighth place with my two teammates, Susanna and Michael.
I like how you get involved with more professional kids of your age.
Being the FBLA advisor is really exciting because we get to travel, we get to work with many students. I get to help the students at a different level. I get to help them with the field, how to prepare resumes, how to dress for an interview, how to go into a business and be better prepared rather than just academically, but the actual work and the field of study that they have to be prepared for.
I got an award for public speaking where I had to prepare a speech, and I did mine on how kids need to be aware about all their career options before they choose one for themselves.
If you would like to be an FBLA in the future, you need to be prepared to work extra outside of the classroom. You need to be able to study outside of the classroom and participate basically like on Saturdays, sometimes even in the summer.
What I like about FBLA is when we go to these field trips and you could just like professionally and then meet new people.
When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now, some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am. Getting stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, our friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Well, that's our our show. Thanks for watching.
As always, if you have a great idea for the show to make it even more awesome, please let us know in room 310. We're always open to new ideas.
Thanks for watching.